Good afternoon. Welcome to Midday Music for December. And we're very pleased to have Joe Scolastico with us as guest organist. After he gets started, he may stop and have a few comments about the music as we go along. But note on the program that there are some pieces and then a chance for us to sing. And Joe's done a great job of setting it up very thematically for Advent, Christmas, and Epiphany. We get to do all three church seasons in one day. Just want to call your attention to a couple of things out of the information desk. There's a little half sheet that some of you are used to. Has the January concert. If there's a snow day change, if you're on our email list, you'll get an announcement. If not, call the church office. And the other dates for February through June are on the back. And because it's close to Christmas, we wanted you to know that we have some CDs remaining that Natsumi Molloy gave us. They're piano pieces of lullabies. And for a donation of $10, you could have one. That might be a perfect gift for new parents, in case you're looking for something. And we also have some gift and honor cards. If you ever give a gift for someone that's to say you made a donation to something that they would appreciate, you could take one of those for any donation and send it to your friend and say you made a donation in their name to the organ fund. So we welcome you, and we welcome Joe. And without further ado, we'll get started. Okay.
Just want to warn you, those of you who are sitting in the front rows, this piece starts loud and stays loud. Oh, it's not a comment I hear a whole lot of. Organ tradition of music accompanying the ministers as they leave the altar by Cesar Franck. Now, some of you that know organ music might be saying, hey, wait a minute. I don't remember this piece as being one of Franck's major works. There were two sets of pieces by Franck that were released, published after he died. One is a set of pieces he wrote when he was young. What is interesting about them is that Franck's major works aren't based on things like chants or chorales or, you know, hymns or whatever, but these pieces are. This is based on a French Noël. All that means is it's a French Christmas song. O Come Divine Messiah. The next piece we're going to do in the Advent section is Bach's Walken auf. It is one of the Schubler chorales, which are transcriptions he wrote of his own, from his own cantatas. Although the cantata comes from is not specifically an Advent cantata, the chorale is often associated with it. And the other piece before we sing is O Emmanuel by Charlie Callahan. He is a local grown composer. He was in the first graduating class of the choir school in Cambridge. He's a very prolific composer. I'll do another piece by him in the Christmas section. So I hope you enjoy the Advent section of this program.
Thank you.
standing or sitting there, you might have seen it. The bench almost fell over at one point, so that may explain those wrong notes at the end there.
A chance to sing, and we have some members of the Braintree Choral Society here. They're going to be having nice strong voices, so you don't have to be shy. Some other great singers in here. So for our first hymn is number 125 in the hymnal. It's only two verses, and that will be followed by number 142, and on that let's do verses 1 and 3. You want to do a little intro to get us in?
Oh, well, yes, and me being a Catholic organist, we'll do very short introduction.
Okay, short okay. Intro.
Thank you.
know, I didn't plan this way, but there's an awful lot of French music on the program with the Franck. People Look East, the tune is a French Noel. Text, by the way, by Eleanor Fargin, who also wrote a hymn you might know, Morning is Broken. And Ding Dong Merrily on High, Peace I Do, is also French. And I think almost, I mean, I certainly didn't plan this, but I think it might be good that we keep the victims of the Strasbourg attack last night in our, in our prayers and thoughts. So again, this is another piece by Charlie Callahan. This will feature the chimes of the organ. The piece after that is two variations on The Holly and the Ivy by Richard Prue. That's actually how you say his name. He used to actually joke about that. Richard Prue is a very, very, again, very prolific composer of sacred music, and I heard, and I believe too, secular music, but is most known for his organ and choral music, mainly in the Episcopal and Catholic churches. As a train enthusiast, and I'm one of those organists who's also a train enthusiast, I'm delighted to know that Richard Prue wrote the theme song for the Union Pacific Railroad, big wheels rolling, or great big rolling railroad in the 70s. He died, about 8 years ago now. The final piece of the Christmas portion is a chorale prelude on Still, 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 an Austrian carol by Paul Mons. Again, another prolific composer, died fairly recently too, lived, I think, well into his 90s, if not 100. He was primarily worked in the Lutheran Church. He wrote, I believe it's 10 sets of 10 chorale preludes, all based on hymn tunes, and we'll hear two of them today. And the first is the one on Still, Still, Still.
Thank you.
Christmas hymns, we start off with 143, Joy to the World, then astute verses 1 and 3.
This year.
Lord,
This is one of the things, I came in here the first day when you decorate for Chris, I said, I looked up and I said, oh, we gotta do Hark the Herald.
Angels.
Yeah. Christmas titles, it's also known, the text, What Star Is This That Beams So Bright. The next piece is the prelude on the Introit of Epiphany by Maurice Durufle. He's one of my favorite composers. He wrote a beautiful Requiem Mass. His organ music, for the most part, except for this, is extremely difficult. This piece is not extremely difficult, though it is tricky in some spots. And he wrote it as a piece of practical music, and I think you'll agree it's the most beautiful piece of practical music you've ever heard. And just so maybe we won't stop, just what child is this? Is it to the tune of Greensleeves? There's a legend that Henry VIII actually wrote that tune as a love song for Anne Boleyn. We all know how that turned out. And the last piece to close out our concert, another Franck from that same collection, another sortie based on two French Christmas carols, one from France and actually a Swiss one, which I apologize if it gets stuck in your head the rest of the day.
Yeah.
So, yeah. All right, number seven, it looks like I have this for. Yeah. Thank you.
next two, because it is.
Yeah, let's do that, yeah.
So our final two hymns are 162, What Child Is This, and We Three Kings. And we're just going to be giving you a teaser on these, one verse of each. Verse 1 of 162 and verse 1 of 172.
Another one, Startslav gets really loud at the end.
Thank you.
Donna, and I want to thank everyone here, the staff of Christ Church. It's very accommodating while I've been coming up and practicing the last few weeks. It really means a lot. I just want to say thank you very much.
Thank you. Just a reminder that Midday Music is free to the community. Invite your friends. We do accept donations in the basket as you leave if you would like to make one. And a little thank you gift for our guest organist today.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much.
And I want to thank Brockton Cable for coming. Thank you, Michael, for Brockton Cable. If you live in Brockton, you can get to watch this again. But also, sometimes it gets posted to YouTube, I believe. And if they tell me what the link is, I can share it with you, and you can get to watch yourself, and people who live in other cities and towns can get to also. So stay tuned for that if you're on that email list. Thanks for coming. Merry Christmas.